Hey everybody, dutchsinse here. 10:50 p.m. Central Time on Thursday, February 19th, 2015. And I'm doing a quick update for you guys. A 6.3 magnitude earthquake just struck off the northeastern shores of Japan. And this comes on top of the 6.8 that struck this past week. Also, 6.2 just to the south over the last several days. Let me just go ahead and show you everything 6.0 and greater. So we have the 6.8 just to the west, and that was 3 days ago. Now 6.3, and also a 6.4 struck today just north of Fiji, and of course at the start of the week, the 6.2 over here in Taiwan. A lot of movement over here in the West Pacific. I just put out an earthquake update, which I'll put a link to down below, which I cover the areas in depth, and put out a slight forecast for areas to watch over the next several days. And we still have that 7.2 and 6.2 on the map, and that's again from the start of this week as well. It's a lot of movement that's been going on around the planet over the last several days. Take this down one notch to 5.0 and greater, and you can really see the activity now, okay? So there's multiple cluster spots in the West Pacific, and in the earthquake forecast I put out, name the areas we need to be watching for possible large movement. Japan is one of them. Southern Japan to Taiwan, still watching for some large-scale movement. Also, Papua New Guinea, watching that area as well. Really quiet in the eastern Pacific, and that's not good. With this amount of movement to the west and no large compensation to the east, we have to watch for it. And that puts the United States, certain spots in the United States, at high risk. Covered that in my update in text down below the video as well, but we are watching Southern California from Los Angeles to Salton Sea for possible movement, as well as Vancouver, British Columbia, south to the coast of Oregon. So it's two small areas, if you really look at the size of the areas that we need to watch, two small areas that we need to be having our eyes on over the next several days for possible movement. Further south in Central America, again, covered this in text below in the previous video, but again, just running it over for you guys. There's a couple swarm locations happening here off the coast of Mexico. That lets you know that there's movement and pressure building down here to Central America as well, which puts Nicaragua, Colombia, Ecuador, El Salvador at risk for possible large-scale movement as well. Mexico City, sitting high and dry above everything else over the last several months now, which is really strange. With all the volcanic eruptions going on throughout Mexico, and we still haven't seen that large-scale movement that I've been watching for now for, well, over a month, been watching for some kind of large movement to come out of Mexico, and there hasn't been. Instead, it's been volcanic eruption after volcanic eruption, which could be relieving the stress, in which case we won't see earthquake activity. We'll continue to see volcanic eruptions in a greater frequency in this region here. And I don't know which is better, you know? I mean, I guess volcanic eruptions is possibly better than a large-scale earthquake in the region. At least with the volcanic eruptions, people can get out of the way. With an earthquake, it's so sudden, causes a lot of damage. I guess we should settle for volcanic eruptions over earthquakes. Let's hope that things calm down overall so we don't have to worry about any of that. As it stands right now, two more earthquakes have popped off deep in the asthenosphere over the last couple hours, and that would be in the West Pacific. The higher these are off the planet, the deeper they are into the Earth. So we have at least two, and if you count these semi-deep earthquakes here, let's say those are at the 100-mile range, whereas these deeper earthquakes are at the 300-mile range. So the plate is moving in the West Pacific. That lets you know. When you see multiple 6.0 earthquakes occur in a region, it lets you know that there's something bigger coming in an adjacent area that hasn't moved yet. Okay? Be safe, guys. Always have an earthquake plan ready. Be prepared, just in case.